All right. Hi there, everyone. Good Saturday afternoon. Thanks for joining us for News 9 Weather on the Web. We wanted to bring you an update because we have some serious rainfall going on in parts of western New Hampshire this afternoon. The National Weather Service within the past 30 minutes putting out a pair of flash flood warnings. One of them is for parts of Sullivan and Merrimack counties. This includes the areas in and around Newport, New London, and right down through, say, Newberry as well. This is just north of the Antrim and Hillsborough area. And this warning goes until 4:45 this afternoon. Another flash flood warning issued for places like Lebanon, Enfield, and Hanover. And that warning goes until about 5:15. What's been happening today is we have had several rounds of rain and thunderstorms basically parked right over the same area, and that is leading to some areas of observed flash flooding. We actually do have ground truth here, and I want to share some storm reports we have with you within the past hour or so. This one coming in from Newport right around 1:30 today, a report right near the center of town here. 2 to 3 feet of water over the road, and the road is closed. Unfortunately, we don't have the name of that road, but it's probably a good idea that you're not driving around at this point in parts of Sullivan County. Another report out of Plainfield, this was right around 1:55, of several road washouts in and around Plainfield. So certainly that means some serious rain has fallen in just the past couple of hours, on the order of 1, 2, even 3 inches. And there still is the chance that we see another inch or two of rain before these downpours and thunderstorms begin to wind down. Let's talk about what a flash flood warning is. It's actually not issued by us, the Stormwatch 9 team. It's issued by the National Weather Service. And when they see that there is sudden and violent flooding ongoing, like we've seen in parts of Sullivan County today, that is when they pull the trigger on a flash flood warning. In this case, it's generated by very heavy rainfall over the same couple of towns for 1, 2, even 3 hours. A good idea to not only move to higher ground if you were to see the floodwaters rising, but especially this bottom point here, you really do not want to be crossing any flooded roads, as that is going to create some serious travel problems and potentially could even be life-threatening. So probably just best to stay off the roads in these areas under the flash flood warning. It's even possible that your phone may have gone off in the past couple of minutes when those flash flood warnings were issued. That's a push notification that's sent to your phone in the case of life-threatening weather. So again, really important to be paying attention to a warning like this, even though we're not talking about severe thunderstorm, tornado warnings, anything like that. This is still one that needs to be taken very seriously. Just south of the flash flood warning area, right into western parts of Hillsborough County, there has been some very heavy rain ongoing in these areas. Hillsborough, Antrim, the east side of Hancock really has seen this steady plume of rain here for the past hour, hour and a half. And there certainly could be some areas of localized flooding outside of the area that is under a flash flood warning. Right down to Milford and Brookline as well. Even some lightning strikes being reported in the past couple of minutes just over the border in extreme northern parts of Massachusetts. And these cells are really just not moving very far, and that is the concern here. Heavy rain over the same areas is going to lead to more issues when it comes to flooding here in the next couple of hours. Out by the Monadnock region, Jaffrey, Fitzwilliam, Troy, even seeing some of the heavier rain right nearby. And you may even be hearing some rumbles of thunder as well. Then through eastern New Hampshire, the rain not nearly as intense, but now starting to back in out of Maine and the Atlantic Ocean. So now even back through the 93 corridor between Concord and Londonderry, starting to see some steady light to moderate rain at this point. Thankfully, for the moment, flooding not a concern along and east of Interstate 93. Of course, this is part of a much larger storm system that we have overhead right now that is going to be keeping the rain, the clouds, the cool temperatures in place. If you've been in tune with the weather so far this weekend, you know it is off to a rough start when it comes to the weather, because we've had just the ongoing rain through most of the morning and now through a good chunk of the afternoon. Again, we're live here on Facebook. Thanks so much for checking in. I want to check in on some of your comments right now. I see Mario is watching, Skip checking in. Please let me know if you have any comments. I'd be happy to answer any questions or look at some of your comments here in real time. This is one really unique feature of being live here on our Facebook page. Let's sort of reset and talk about why we're even bringing you a weather update in the first place. We have had numerous showers and thunderstorms extending through western parts of New Hampshire, and they really have been in no hurry to go anywhere. With that heavy rain over the same areas for multiple hours, that is leading to the concern of flash flooding. And this is mostly an issue for parts of Sullivan and extreme southern parts of Grafton counties. These are the warning areas here. We have two flash flood warnings in effect right now. One including the northeastern part of Sullivan County and extreme western parts of Merrimack County. This does not include Warner, but just up the road here through New London, Springfield, Grantham. That's where that flash flood warning is in effect until about 4:45 this afternoon. If the rain stops, and certainly if the water levels go down on some of the area roadways, it's possible that the National Weather Service would discontinue this warning before 4:45. Another flash flood warning in effect for areas like Lebanon, Enfield, and Hanover in southwestern parts of Grafton County. That warning goes until 5:15. You can actually see here that most of the rain is south of this warning area, but they've already picked up a solid 2 to 3 inches of rain in just the past couple of hours. And a couple of ground truth reports we actually have for you and can share with you. This one out of Newport right around 1:30. This is right near the center of town. We don't have an exact road or an exact point in Newport where this took place, but law enforcement reporting 2 to 3 feet of water over a roadway, and that road is closed. Another report out of Plainfield of several road washouts just before 2 o'clock today. So certainly a lot to talk about, and of course here's some reminders of what a flash flood warning means. It's something to take very seriously here, and you especially do not want to be driving out in this kind of weather. Any flooded roadway, or really any road where you just can't even see the road, whether it's an inch of water or a foot of water, can be very unsafe to travel through. Then we have more areas of steady rain back through western parts of Hillsborough County and down right near the Massachusetts state line, places like Brookline, New Ipswich, really seeing the rain falling at a good clip. Maybe you're even hearing some thunder. It seems like there is some lightning just over the border in northwestern parts of Middlesex County in Massachusetts. All right, I want to get back to some of your Facebook comments here on our live feed on the WMUR Facebook page. Let's see. Steady rain in Barrington being reported by Robert. And yeah, that's with this shield of rain that's backing in out of Maine this afternoon. Thankfully, flooding not a concern in the Barrington area at this point. Thomas wants to know if there's any chance of flooding in the Manchester area later on this afternoon. Certainly a possibility. Really want to highlight here that right now the bulk of the flooding concerns are in extreme western parts of the state. So Manchester not currently, or really even in the near term, expected to see flooding, but we will keep a close eye on that as some of these rain bands start to pivot in out of the east. If it starts pouring for multiple hours at a time, then we know we have a problem. Thankfully, we're not at that point just yet. Teresa, do you think it's going to be raining a lot this summer? Really hard to say, obviously, right? We're just getting kind of our feet wet in the summer season, but not off to a great start here, although at least summer is right around the corner officially, and it looks like the weather should start to clear out here in the next couple of days. Certainly nothing like what we're seeing out there today. All right, Kurt is saying very little rain in the Concord area right now. And yeah, Concord's been right on the edge of this. So it's been a relatively dry morning and early afternoon in Concord. Now the rain's starting to fill in out of the east here as the storm is starting to get its act together near Cape Cod. Ron says it's wet and chilly in Brentwood. Ben, Lisbon, nowhere near it. Robert's saying there's over an inch here. Robert, if you could tell me where you are, that would actually be a really helpful report. Thank you. Deborah is asking, what about Rochester? Thankfully, no real issues in terms of flooding in Rochester, but some steady light to moderate rain is really kind of going off and on. I'll give you a closer view of the flooding area, and that is, again, including parts of Sullivan and southern parts of Grafton County. It's these red boxes here where there is flash flooding ongoing this afternoon and could be continuing for the next couple of hours as an additional 1 to even 2 inches of rain is possible. Again, really along and west of 89 here up through parts of Sullivan and Grafton counties. All right, let's see. Sarah says, any concerns for the outdoor music festival in Swansea? And certainly, yeah, there is some heavier rain in and around Keene and Swansea. Most of the real extreme rainfall is a little bit off to your east, but you're still kind of in this area that we need to keep a close eye on in the next couple of hours. Let's see. We have Renee checking in from Peterborough, where it has stopped raining for the moment. Thank you for that report, Renee. Daniel's asking, any flooding around Alexandria? And that's the good news. A lot of this activity is west of Alexandria. So Alexandria is right about here. It looks like the rain in the Newfound Lake region has been pretty light to this point, with a lot of the really extreme rainfall taking place really north of Lake Sunapee here, right along and just west of 89 through the New London, Grantham, Springfield stretch. Not quite to Claremont. Claremont has kind of avoided a lot of the heaviest rainfall so far, and that's why the actual city of Claremont is just outside of the flash flood warning area. Linda reporting that it's pouring in Pelham right now. And yeah, some of that steadier rain over the eastern part of the state is now starting to back in. So we are still keeping a very close eye on some of this heavy rainfall. Of course, these flash flood warnings continue here for the next couple of hours. We'll be bringing you more updates here on our Facebook page and over on WMUR Channel 9 itself. We'll bring you more updates, of course, as we learn more about this ongoing flash flood situation and certainly the rain that really just will not let up in parts of western New Hampshire right now. Hope everyone has a safe afternoon. Thanks so much for checking in today. And again, we'll bring you more updates as we need to bring you to them. Have a great day.